Jonathan, Xavier, inasmuch as you insist on being an outsider and laughing at the rules and traditions of our advanced civilization, I am exiling you to a place which has no adherence to either. I have no choice but to sentence you to Earth.
That was a sneak peek at the sci-fi dark comedy musical romance B-movie throwback film, The Ghastly Love of Johnny X, showing tonight at the Tower Theater, presented by Fresno Filmworks.
And the director, Paul Bunnell, and the star of the film, Will Keenan, joining us live right here on the set. Good morning. Nice to have you gentlemen here.
Good morning, Fresno!
We're here.
Oh, wake
boy.
Up, Fresno!
Here we are.
Boys. Raging raisins, come on down.
Right, we'll just raise anything we can.
We just had his coffee, folks.
Well, nice to have you here. Thanks for coming all the way up from Hollywood. We appreciate it.
It's a sincere sensation. I'm glad to be here. Yes.
Well, first of all, tell our viewers about the film. Let it kind of clue them in on what's it about.
It is my prediction as the very last black and white widescreen musical feature ever to be shot on film. Who the heck else is going to do that besides this man right here?
Thank you. Well, I like to say it's about 106 minutes. So, yeah.
Okay.
Oh. You know, but it's really about having a great time at the movies. You know, it's one of those old-fashioned things. You go out to the movies, you see it on the big screen, you get your popcorn, you bring your best date, or, you know, your standby date. And you know, or a prune, whatever you like, and you come out and you just have fun at the movies, you know.
I love it.
And it's shot on film. You know, this is actually a real movie shot on 35mm black and white, the very last of the Kodak Plus X film stock.
Wow. Okay, so you're talking about that technology, but you're holding up a DVD. What's the scoop?
What is this?
That comes out on Tuesday. It's been picked up for distribution, and this
is a. Can we get a close up?
That's right. You know, it comes
out. Who's that good looking guy on the cover of that thing?
Right there.
Hey.
On Tuesday.
Wow.
You know, so that's exciting for people to see in their homes and VOD and that sort of thing.
Yes.
But you're going to get your once-in-a-lifetime chance to see it, Fresno and gentlemen, right here in beautiful downtown Fresno at the Tower Theater.
Wow, the Tower
historic,
Theater?
Historic.
The historic theater.
Landmark.
What time, how much?
Well, how much do you have?
How much do you need?
Yes. No, we would love to have you there. You know, be our guest, but it's at 8 o'clock, and I think the tickets vary. You know,
Did you just hand out free tickets to all of Fresno?
No, Fresno, come on down!
Come
on down,
free.
It's on us tonight. No, it's going to be at 8 o'clock, and how much is the ticket price for this?
Anyone? It's free. He's
going once.
Do I hear $2.95? Do I hear $3.95?
Sold to the man with the spittoon haircut.
I'll take it, thank you very much.
If you bring prunes, it's free. Okay, black and white. Yeah. Was it shot in black and white, or was that done in post?
No, it was actually photographed on black and white stock, and boy, did I get a lot of slack over that one.
Why?
You know? Well, they said, why are you making your movie in black and white? I mean, you won't be able to sell it foreign in color. You know, they like color movies.
Mm. Why not shoot it in color and turn it black and white?
I disagree with that. Look at the great Kevin McCarthy there, and look at the great Will Keenan chomping on that black and white licorice.
Awesome, awesome.
Here's the thing with black and white film. You cannot duplicate that with a digital medium.
No.
You turn color into black and white, you can tell. Mm-hmm. This was shot on black and white, printed on black and white stock, and what you're going to see tonight is a 35mm print from the original camera negative.
Awesome.
So,
great
you know,
job.
I think it's going to look fantastic.
Who came up with the idea of the film?
Well, that would be me.
Uh-huh.
Yes, I wanted to do another. I started making movies when I was like 10, 11 years old.
Uh-huh.
You know, so
that was
like 8, 9 years ago, right? So anyway, I started making pictures, and I said, one day I want to do a real movie. So I shot this thing on 35mm, and was the idea whose idea was it? Because that was my idea.
Well, good.
Well, we got to hear from Will here. Will, tell us about your character.
My character's name's Johnny X. He's an alien, right, from outer space. And he looks like this.
Side-casting.
I don't normally dress like this. Reno! No, I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Fresno!
Yeah, where are you?
But it was the first time, and I've done a lot of independent films. They call them kind of like cult movies.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it was the first time I was offered a role that was like the strong, silent type, right?
Yeah.
And this is an exact replica of what Brando wore in The Wild One.
Yeah.
And I got to sing for the first time. But I think the interesting part, do we have time here?
Please.
The interesting part is that
don't
we
sing.
Started. Don't say it! I'm going to tell your secrets right now. Yeah. we started shooting this in 2004. We shot for a week, and Paul ran out of money.
Yeah.
Right. So. And then he put together some clips, and he thought, "Oh, it's beautiful. People are just I'm gonna get a three-picture deal, right?" Yeah. And then for every year for 6 years, he would call up the whole cast, and it's a large cast.
I love it.
And he'd say, "Hey, you haven't gained any weight, have you?
Yeah. Still got hair, don't you?
Still got that hair? Yeah. Okay, cool. Because I think I got the money, and I think we're gonna go." After the second or third year, I lost faith. I was like, okay, this is never happening. I would still take the calls.
Her?
Finally, in 2010 or something.
Yeah, 2010.
He calls up and he says, "I think I got the money." And I was like, "Yeah."
You should do a movie on doing this movie.
Well, they did shoot.
Behind the scenes stuff on the DVD.
Awesome.
Yes.
No, it really was a production that was spanned almost a decade in the making.
Yeah.
But so I like to say, I'll give you 10 years if you give me 90 minutes of your time and come out and see The Ghastly Love of Johnny X tonight at the Tower Theater.
We dare you.
Yes. Throw that challenge.
Get there before 8 o'clock so you can get your nice seat, get your popcorn, get your prunes, get your drinks, whatever, sitting next to your nice date. That's tonight.
Awesome. Congratulations. We're so proud of you. Will it take you another 10 years to do another one?
No. Yes. No. Another one next year.
Awesome.
What's it called?
Rocket Girl.
Oh.
Yes. Sounds good.
And I'm playing the lead in that one, too.
Wait a minute.
I just want to remind you can head over to KMPH.com and click on news links for a direct link to the film's official. This is the official website, not unofficial, official, gentlemen.
That's right.
Absolutely.
Thank you. Congratulations, and thank you for being on a great day.
Great to be here.
Good,
good morning.
All right.
Goodbye, Fresno.
It's 8:47 still to come. We'll check into your exclusive 10-day forecast.
First, we want to celebrate some great Valley graduates.